Hi friends, this is Raj Kiran Das, design, creative design teacher from Opus Private Limited. Here today we want to talk about how creativity, art and design can be developed. We are talking about in terms of CAT preparation for NIFT and DAT preparation for NID. What is very important in today's world is that before you endeavor into this kind of course, you must have an inclination of how to study art, how to explore creativity, and then gradually convert that into your design. Every human being is actually given and blessed with artistic ideas in its own way. You know, what we need to do is like we need to explore them so that we can better our artwork and master it in such a way so that we can endeavor into creative field in product designing, in fashion designing, in textile designing, graphic designing, and likewise a lot of design careers we can choose on. So here what we see that if you don't have anything and you want to draw a few shapes and form, how do you actually enjoy in creating them? So you basically create a few lines, you know, join up them, just explore, keep exploring, keep enjoying, you know, and then master it in such a way so that this becomes in its own way an expression. And this expression need not be, you know, associated with directly or indirectly with certain things that you want to visualize. You just have to go with the flow of your energy so that these ideas keep on overlapping with each other and connecting with each other, and then it actually gives you a kind of a new horizon, new visuals to think about so that these expressions can be developed into some more details. So the detailing of the design over here, if you see that here I'm trying to put up a few more expression within them or outside of this lines periphery, okay. So here you are not actually thinking about exactly what you are supposed to be doing within it. Okay, it is just a conscious or unconscious mind can be used into a creative expression. Okay, so this creative expression might lead to a particular direction, might not lead to a particular direction, but it's a kind of a habit which actually you need to tend to incorporate within yourself so that later on you don't get stuck with your design. Creation. So when you actually keep designing this way without any particular thinking, without any particular thoughts, and this design expression might give you such ideas so that these ideas can later on be utilized for a particular direction in such a way which I just can show you over here, that you want to visualize this as a kind of a t-shirt. Okay, you just have to get a shape out of it, and then a small top, a structure, a pattern, a print, you know, is developed over here. Okay, you may transfer the same thing on a small product design, say for example a mug or a jar, you know, or a glass, somewhat like this, you know, you can make it short depending upon how you can incorporate these design ideas for a particular design story. So these are the kind of things which is known as doodling. Okay, doodling is a basic exercise for all the designers, all the artists that they look forward to when they are not particularly inclined in creating particular in direction. You have to keep on exploring and enjoying this particular fact. Okay, so doodling is a kind of exercises which actually give our creative juice flow out. Okay. So friends, I hope you'll like to develop this kind of doodling exercises at home and try to practice in the initial stage how you can endeavor into this kind of creative art CAT and GAT preparation for NID and NIFT. Okay, thank you friends for joining me. Okay, hope I see you in the next video with some new interesting relevant tools. Okay, till then.